It's been a while since I posted any new videos, so I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. I've moved a couple states away from the boat, but I have done some projects and I'll keep some small projects going. So here's a quick update for you guys. It's moving day. Empty house. I don't think it's been this clean since I moved in. Actually, it was clean when I moved in. That's pretty good. And this is what my wife does. She says she's practicing for when the boat's completed.
Don't get me.
Okay, so I finally brought my stick. It shows, although the shaft is in the way, it shows vertical and horizontal alignment. These pieces. This piece here is, goes up there. And it definitely fits this time, and we'll fill that hole with a dowel and epoxy. Okay, so this one's left. It's in a bit of rough shape, but we'll sand it down, see how it looks. Sorry, I've done some sanding and scraping. These ones are good, a little bit of filling. It's clouding up and getting dark, so I'm more concerned with coating than filling today. Okay, so they're all sealed, and we'll put some screws in and paint and fair next time we're here. Okay, so here's some small wooden blocks that used to be part of the rigging. Most of them are in fairly good shape and stay fine. They appear to have bronze wheels on them, stainless steel fittings. As you can see, the finish, not so great. And these ones here, probably the worst of the two for the wheels spinning. So basically I'm going to refinish these blocks. I'll use this as some practice to do some splicing on these wood strop blocks and some whipping. And I probably won't use them on the boat in the rigging, but I may use them for flag halyards or something on the boat. I'm not sure. I suspect that I'm actually going to buy new blocks that come apart, because these ones look like if I took them apart, it would be a total rebuild, and I'd have to, I'm not sure, but I believe these are either probably copper nails, which I do have. But yeah, if I take them completely apart, I'm not sure if I'll be able to get them back together. But I'll give it a shot and see how we go. Some other projects, I'm gonna try to refinish these for the mast, the spreaders. And then see how they come up. I'm a bit concerned about the ends, which are starting to check. And obviously none of the rigging that holds this in place exists anymore. So I'll either be using some bronze or stainless steel. My preference would be bronze. And I think I'm gonna build a whole new mast by the time we get back to working on the mast and the rest of the boat is done. I think the mast will have deteriorated a bit too far. It's about due for replacement. Looks like there's a bit of rot at the base where it fits into the mast step. And at the top, there's no mast head or sheaves. There's just a giant hole which is letting the weather into the mast. You've seen in a previous video, I made a hatch. This one was my first attempt and it's slightly small. Person probably can't get through it, but I am gonna end up putting it together without a deck light in it. And so this would be the inside tongue and groove. Cover it the same way as the old one And I think I'm going to use this as a lazarette hatch. It's about 19 and a half inches by 19 and a half inches. So a bit small to fit through, especially in a hurry, but probably large enough to fit behind the fuel tank on the back deck under the tiller, just to either store propane if I choose to go with a propane stove, or more likely a rope locker to store mooring lines. Okay, so here is my relatively inexpensive bandsaw. Bandsaw blade, time to be changed. So I have a new smaller blade, as in not as deep. This is a 6 mil blade. The one that came on it is a 10 mil blade. So we'll be changing the bandsaw blade, doing a flutter test, and setting it all up, and I'll show you that. Roars from underneath the galley and the nav station, and next to the ice box on the boat. Not quite sure what wood they are. They look like they're still in fairly good condition. They're not wobbly. They're fairly strong, well put together. So I think I'm going to clean them up. Definitely sand down the faces and refinish them and see if they come up with the color I expect. Also have in here 4 cabinet doors. So I'll need to clean up the brass hardware and I'll see how they come up as well. They look like they're made out of 2 different types of wood. As you can see, the slats are different than the main body in coloring. So we'll sand those down, stain them up, and see how they look. Hopefully I can reuse them without having to rebuild them.